Our group is Anastasia, Raven, Kiwan, Thomas, and Sveta, which is me. Our group read books by and studied the author, Louisa May Alcott. Louisa May Alcott was born on November 29, 1832. She grew up in Germantown, Pennsylvania, but moved about 20 times in her first year. Because her family was very poor, in 1833, they moved to Boston, Massachusetts, into the house known as the Orchard House, where the story of Little Women was written. Her sisters were Elizabeth Alcott, Annie Alcott, and Abigail Alcott. Her mother was Abby May Alcott. She was an activist for several causes and one of the first paid social workers in the state of Massachusetts. Her father was Amos Bronson Alcott. Louisa and her sisters were educated by her father. He was a self-educated man. He opened and ran multiple schools, and in them, he banned corporal punishment and introduced field trips, PE, music, art, and nature studies, and encouraged students to ask questions. He was a transcendentalist and influenced how education is today. He was a man of hope, trying to making his dreams become reality. He ended up dying on March 4th, 1888 of mercury poisoning, 2 days before his daughter, Louisa.
Louisa May Alcott was very lucky to have such amazing family friends that included Henry David Thoreau and Ralph Waldo Emerson. These individuals helped teach Louisa and influenced her writings. This was a very easy task for these family and friends, for they were writers themselves.
Not only was Louisa educated by her father, but she was also taught by some family friends who were writers during the Transcendentalist writing era. She started growing an interest in writing and started doing some herself. She used a pen name Flora Fairfield before she was really ready to start her career in writing, but switched to A.M. Bernard in 1862 when she started writing short stories and poems that began to appear in magazines. She did this until 1865 when she started doing her and using her real name. The very first book she wrote was when she was 22 years old, which she titled Flower Fables. She wrote this book of short stories for Ralph Waldo Emerson's daughter, Ellen. Remember, Emerson was one of the family friends who taught her when she was young. Writing Little Women, which is another one of her books, brought her great financial success and helped her family out of poverty. Recall, her family was very poor because of her father's endeavors. By helping her family, she accomplished one of her main goals in life, which was to become financially stable again. Lisa wrote many books. This includes Flower Fables, Hospital Sketches, the Eight Cousins series, and Little Women, which is also a series. Little Women was the first book written in the series in 1868, followed by Good Wives in 1869. In 1880, the two books were issued in a single volume entitled Little Women. L- Little Men in 1871 and Joe's Boys in 1886 were written as sequels to a very popular book, Little Women.
Louisa wrote novels and books for children and young adults alike. She based her books on how she felt and what she believed in. She also based many of her books on her life experiences and circumstances. For example, in the series Little Women, she portrayed herself as the role of Jo and her three sisters as Jo's three sisters. Although Jo married in the book, Louisa never did marry in real life. Louisa wrote Little Women at Orchard House at the desk that her father made for her.
Louisa May Alcott was no stereotypical female. She wouldn't be friends with a girl unless they were willing to get dirty, nor a boy unless he could climb a tree. She would never back down from a challenge. She was known as a spinster hero of all eras for never being married during her time, but yet being very successful in the end, showing that you don't need a man. Even though she was never married, she did take in May's daughter, little Lulu, after May passed away. Louisa was also involved in the women's suffrage movement, becoming the first woman to register to vote. Her dad also supported female rights. Her thought was that everyone was equal and deserved all the same rights. She based Jo, the tomboy in Little Women, on herself. Just like her, this character was determined to become a writer. Females in the 1800s were obsessed with having big backsides and small waist, but Louisa didn't care about how she looked. Alcott challenged conventional beliefs about women in the 1800s. I was inspired by Louisa May Alcott because she would take action on what she thought was right instead of sitting there letting it happen. Thank you.